I want to talk about the decision of President Edgar Lungu to choose Professor Nkanduluo as the running mate. And I want to tell you, because this is a very big prophetic mistake. It's a very big prophetic mistake. It's a mistake, a very big prophetic mistake. I see Lafouke Muke. God bless you, everybody. Let me know where you're watching me in every part of the nation of Zambia. My name is Prophet Ian Genesis, and I am the man that is carrying the Genesis mandate, demonstrating the God of the beginning in the now. God bless you, everybody. God bless you. You know, as you are watching me, you know that I am one of the few prophets that is not that is not a partisan prophet. I don't belong to any political party, as it were. So I am allowed to speak by God, and I'm allowed to speak the mind of God. So as you are watching this video, don't forget, as you are watching this video, it's also your prophetic moment, and it's your prophetic season for now. During the adoption ship of Patriotic Front, they have made a lot of mistakes. The adoption, starting from the adoption of the Patriotic Front, they have made a lot of errors. They have made a lot of mistakes. They have left good people out, and they have brought in certain people that were supposed to be fired. They have brought in certain people that were not supposed to be there. And that is the biggest error that they have committed. This is the biggest error. Those of you that are watching me from outside Zambia, there are people are asking, what is a running mate? A running mate is someone that the president chooses, that when they win the election, that person will become the vice president of the republic. Number one, starting from the adoption process of the PF. Listen, even if God says that a particular person is going to win an election, the decisions that person begins to make, and I want all political parties that are filing in their nominations after today to know, the decisions that you make, they can determine whether you become president or you don't become president. The decisions that you make, the people you adopt, the people you put as running mate, they determine the spiritual circumference of what happens. Today, President Edgar Gachagua Lungu has made the biggest mistake he has ever made in his political career. And I am not too compromised to say it. The president has made the biggest mistake he has ever made in his political career. And it's going to be very, very difficult to spiritually align with him. It's going to be very, very difficult. This is an error that has been committed. This is an error. And if you are PF, and you are a proud PF, you know, deep down in your knower, you know that this is a mistake. This is a mistake. I have nothing against Professor Nkanduluo as a person. But remember, when I was prophesying about people that the PF should not adopt, the Lord spoke to me that Professor Nkanduluo should not be adopted for Munali. How many of you remember that prophetic word? I gave a prophecy and I said Professor Nkanduluo must not be adopted for Munali, because if she's adopted for Munali, she was going to lose. How do you take somebody that a prophecy has been released that particular person was going to lose as an MP and make them the deputy president? I spoke about it. When they just started the campaigns and everything about who they were going to choose for Munali constituency. And I said, if the PF want to win Munali constituency, they must not choose Professor Nkanduluo. And when they did not choose Professor Nkanduluo, we celebrated God because they heard the voice of God. But when the president of the Republic of Zambia comes back and says that he has chosen the same person that was rejected by the altar to be the running mate, that's a mistake. I'm telling you, this is a mistake. This is a mistake. This is a very big mistake. And I don't know if constitutionally, because I'm not a politician, I don't know if constitutionally the president can reverse that decision. But it's a big mistake. It's a very, 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 very big, big, big mistake. And This is an opportunity for Hakainde Hichilema to capitalize on the mistake. He can capitalize on this because this is a mistake. This is a mistake. I can tell you here and now that the elections of Zambia are in a place of uncertainty. I can tell you here, after this move today, the presidency of President Edgar Chagwalungu is in uncertainty. I can tell you that. As a prophet, I can tell you. As a prophet, I can tell you without fear of contradiction, this will mean a lot of work for anyone that is praying that President Edgar Lungu should continue his presidency. Because things have now become difficult. Things have become difficult now. If you are a prophet, you are a pastor, you are an evangelist, and you were praying that President Edgar Lungu comes back into power. No. No. This is a mistake. This is a mistake. This is a very big mistake. I can tell you that. This is a very big mistake, and it's gonna cost a lot. This mistake is going to cost a lot. It's going to cost a lot. I love President Edgar Lungu as a person. I love him. I love that man. I love him as a person. But today he has made a mistake that I was praying by God that he should not make this mistake. I was praying that the president should not make the mistake that he has made. And unfortunately, he has made that mistake. This is a mistake. Choosing Professor Nkanduluwo as running mate is a mistake. Even Madam Jean Kapata is better than Nkanduluwo. This Lusaka, things are messed up in the spirit. I'm telling you, if you are PF, today things are messed up in the spirit. They are messed up. My God. Wow. Yes. No, I'm not calling you, baby. This is a mistake. This is a mistake, and I'm telling you, this is a mistake. There are people that are saying, no, prophet must continue preaching the word of God, blah, blah, blah. I've been prophesying before you came to my platform. I preach the word of God every day. But I'm telling you, this is a terrible mistake. The spiritual standing of any election, when God chooses you as a leader, you need a lot of wisdom in order to continue as a leader in that dimension. I'm telling you, those of you that are prophetic, those of you that are men of God, those of you that hear God, those of you that have had the fear of God, you can bear with me today that President Edgar Chagwalungu, His Excellency, has made a mistake today. He's made a very, very, very terrible mistake. This is a mistake. It's a mistake. I can see Mark M. Garay saying it's a very big mess. Yes. Somebody saying maybe it's God's will for that mistake. It's a miss. For me, many people, the past few minutes, were asking me, Prophet Ian, what is your opinion and what is your take on what President Edgar Lungu today has done, and he has chosen Professor Nkanduluwo as running mate. I can tell you without fear of contradiction, today the president has made a mistake, and that mistake will cost him a lot of things. That's a big mistake. If there are people that can see and can hear God and they are very close to the president, they should have advised the president against it. Because the president has now lost UNSA. The president has now lost CBU. This is a mistake. It's a very big mistake. Ish. Wow, this is a mistake. Well, we thank God. We can only now see. Yeah, Mwandiwe is saying, for me, I'm waiting for your June prophecy. Yes, wait for the June. That is why I said, I am not going to prophesy who will become the next president until June. Because there are a lot of errors that I was seeing in the realms of the spirit. Whilst this person is saying this, this person is saying that, this person is saying this, I was praying that there are certain errors that people will not make. And they have started to make the errors that they are not supposed to make. I told you, many of you that are my followers, I told you to say, I am only going to prophesy who will become the next president of Zambia in June. And I'm still in June. I'm still. The Chilufya is saying, I'm also waiting for June. You know, I am one of the most accurate prophets living now on the surface of the earth. And when I prophesy, I never miss. Never. When I hit a prophecy, it's done. It's done. Now, this is my advice to Hakainde Hichilema. This is my advice. On Wednesday, don't make the same mistake that the Patriotic Front have made. This is an advice. Somebody saying, man of God, is it possible for you to brief us why Nkanduluo is not the right candidate? When there was adoption for Munali constituency, I said it that God has rejected the candidacy of Professor Nkanduluo. I said it. Point blank. I said Professor Nkanduluo should not be adopted in Munali. And I said it. So when you ask me about why she is not the best person, if she was not good for Munali, how can she be good for the nation? Somebody said, I thought you already said ECL. I never said who will become the president. Oh, go back to the videos. I said I will prophesy in June. I said I will prophesy in June. That's what I said. I will prophesy in June. Those of you that continuously watch my videos, I said I will prophesy in June. Because there is a person saying here that I have changed. I've changed what? I haven't changed anything. My position is still intact. I am still here, the same person. June is in 2 weeks' time, is June. I'm going to give you what God is saying over the election. My name is Prophet Ian Genesis, and I am the man that is carrying the Genesis mandate, demonstrating the Lord God of the beginning in the now. Wherever you're watching me from, God bless you. I just felt within my spirit that I should share my disappointment. Brian is one of my top fans. He's saying he never said ECL will win. I've never said anybody will win. Brian is one of my followers. And there is Bridget saying, yes, you said in June. So I don't understand why somebody is talking about. I said, everyone that follows me, we tell you that I said I was going to prophesy in June. Muke is saying, yes, he mentioned June. Yes. So the problem with many Zambians is that they are following too many prophets. So when another prophet says something, they are thinking Ian Genesis has said it. Please. If I have not said it, let me remind you what I said. I see President Edgar Lungu aligned spiritually. I said, I see President Edgar Lungu aligned spiritually. And I said, the alignment I see in the realm of the spirit, HH needs to be aligned spiritually because there is no alignment in the realm of the spirit for HH. And I said that between when was that month? I think it was February. I said between February and June, between February and June, HH must find men of God to align him. Then I will give the presidential prophecy in June. I said I will give the presidential prophecy in June. I know what I said. We are still coming in June. 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 If I said President Edgar Lungu will win, what is the point of me coming to prophesy in June? Think about it. If I said President Edgar Lungu will win, what is the point of me coming to prophesy in June? What's the point? What's the point? Many of you, you watch too many prophets. So you are confused. You don't know who said what, who didn't say what. You don't know who said what, who didn't say what. But bottom line is this. President Edgar Lungu today has made a big mistake in his political career. Full stop. Someone is saying, yes, Papa, you said you are going to say in June. Yeah. I don't understand why some people are confused. I don't understand. But the Lord bless you. Keep standing, keep praying. We are praying for Zambia. We are praying for Zambia. Bigger. I'm not praying for PF. I'm not praying for UPND. I'm praying for Zambia. Zambia is bigger than PF. Zambia is bigger than UPND. Zambia is bigger than any political party. So I'm not praying particularly for a political party. I'm praying for Zambia. I'm praying for the preservation of Zambia. There are things that I have seen that I'm going to talk about in my June prophecy that are very scary. Today, I only came to issue my continuation of prophecy that I began on Professor Nkanduluo. That's the only thing I came to issue out. But as a matter of fact, there are things that I have seen in the realms of the spirit. There are things that I've seen. McLean is saying people are confused. Is this June? Is this June? This is not June. This is still May. God bless you, everybody. God bless you. Man of God, who is going to be the running mate for HH? I don't know. I don't know. God has hidden it from me. The same way God hid it from me, who was going to be the running mate for Edgar Lungu. That is the same way God hid it from me, who is going to be the running mate of HH. On this matter of the running mate, I am as blank as you. On the issue of the running mate, I am as blank as you. So I'm waiting for HH to do... Someone is saying, man of God, will you be at Mandayu today? You want to take me to Mandayu? You want to take me to Mandayu? God bless you. God bless you. Listen, any prophet that tells you that he knows everything is actually a false prophet. Somebody said, man of God, why didn't you call President Lungu for... No, I don't have President Lungu's number. I don't have his number. I don't have his phone number. The man is the head of state. To see him, it's very, very complicated. I don't have his number. And even if I was to call him, I wouldn't have told him who was going to be the running mate because that is where God put wisdom. You understand? God gives you wisdom as a man to make certain decisions. So even if I was going to meet President Edgar Lungu, I was not going to tell him who was going to become the running mate. Because it was within his spiritual wisdom to know. To know. And even if I meet HH today or tomorrow, I can't tell him who to become the running mate, because that is one part of this. You know, the 2021 election is a very, very spiritual election. And it's an election that in the realm of the spirit, it has a lot of things. So the issue of the running mates, I can tell you this without fear of contradiction. I am a prophet of God, but I tell you, God did not reveal to me who was going to become the running mate of PF. God did not reveal to me who was going to become the running mate for UPND. So as they do it, we see. As they do it, we see. As they do it, we see. God bless you and keep on following in Jesus' mighty name. Wait for my prophecy for June. That prophecy is one thing that is going to have a lot of things. By the way, the battles of President Edgar Lungu have just begun. Now, today, the battles have just begun. So only after that, hear God. God bless you in Jesus' name. Shalom for now.